Good afternoon, Aaron. Throughout the morning, people have been stopping by here, offering to help the mayor and his wife in any way that they can. The mayor says he's been overwhelmed by the outpouring of support by the community, and despite the loss, he and his family are very grateful that no one was hurt.
It's our hope to be able to restore it to its original beauty.
But that is going to take a lot of work. Around 5 o'clock yesterday afternoon, fire was reported at the mayor's home on Grand Street. It would eventually go to 4 alarms. The house was built around 1900, and the fire chief says the balloon construction at that time allowed the fire to spread quickly. But the materials used also mean, despite the damage, it can be rebuilt.
This old-style house has thicker lumber, takes a lot to burn through.
This is where investigators believe the fire started, outside on a porch. Neighbors were concerned about the fire spreading. Today, their concerns are elsewhere.
It was scary, but our hearts go out to the Soldatis. They're just wonderful people.
And their home was a gathering place for the neighborhood.
I was thinking it's going to change the whole nature of the hill if this house is taken down.
But the Soldatis vow that's not going to happen. Traditions like the neighborhood Christmas party will go on.
In fact, this is going to be our 25th year.
There was a sign of hope today as the family pet feared loss turned up hungry but otherwise all right. Still, many precious photographs and family items were lost.
I had built this roll-top desk. It was mahogany and cherry, and sort of put my heart and soul in it. And this course I took one time, and so that kind of breaks my heart that that's lost.
But now he says it's time to put that behind them and look to the future.
We'll start rebuilding more memories in this house, you know.
The state fire marshal's office says so far the only thing they've ruled out is natural causes, as there was no lightning in the area at the time. However, they also add that there is nothing suspicious about this fire. Reporting live in Somersworth, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.